The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department confirms another Filipino casualty in the Israel-Hamas war. Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo says a fourth Filipino has been killed in the conflict. The victim was one of three missing Filipinos in Israel. And just like the first three Filipino fatalities, the fourth victim was also a caregiver. The Filipino victims were killed by Hamas militants. Over a dozen Filipinos who fled the violence in Israel are back home. The Philippine government vowing to give assistance as they try to recover from their harrowing experiences. More in this report.
Another batch of Filipinos repatriated from Israel arrived at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Wednesday afternoon. 15 of them are caregivers, while one is a hotel worker. The Department of Migrant Workers says another OFW was left in Abu Dhabi after failing to receive medical clearance to board the flight to Manila due to high blood pressure. For some of the repatriates, the trauma from the Hamas group's attack is still fresh. Maylene Rivera was only 5 kilometers away from the Gaza border. She hid in a bomb shelter with her employer for days without food and without water.
Nag-message na po ako sa family ko na, anak, mahal na mahal ko kayo, ingatan niyo yung sarili niyo. Huwag niyong isipin si mama, okay lang ako, doon din sa asawa ko. Ingatan mo yung mga anak natin, mahal na mahal kita. Hindi mo alam kung mabubuhay ka pa o hindi na. Sinabayan ko lang po ng dasal. Yan po yun. Hanggang sa dumating po yung rescue team sa amin.
For Kathleen Tolentino, she could not forget the sound of missiles being intercepted by Israel's air defense system, the Iron Dome in Tel Aviv.
Traumatic po yung sound para sa akin, kaya po naisipan ko po uwi na lang po ako kaysa po kikita ako ng malaki, pero yung mental health ko po hindi na po healthy.
The returning OFWs will be given psychosocial services by the Health and Social Welfare Departments. While in Tel Aviv, they also received $500 each. Upon arriving in Naiya, they were taken to the VIP lounge where they received 50,000 pesos from the DMW, 50,000 pesos from OWA, and livelihood packages from the DSWD.
They're leading the assistance, yung assistance to individuals in crisis situation. That's a range of 15 to 20,000 depending on the situation ng individual. As well as we're going to give them livelihood grants, gagamitin natin ulit yung sustainable livelihood program.
Another repatriation flight with 14 OFWs is set to depart from Tel Aviv Wednesday and is expected to arrive in the Philippines on Friday. Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Eduardo De Vega says 80 of the 137 Filipinos stranded in Gaza have expressed interest to come home. They are just waiting for the opening of the Rafah border so they can enter Egypt.
Wala pang bansa nakapag-repatriate ng kanilang mga mamamayan from Gaza. Ganun pa man, handa yung ating embahada sa Cairo. At least 78 have indicated na gusto nilang, well, they're ready at any time, no? So, iniintay lang natin na mangyari ito. Ang sabi ng Israeli ambassador na be ready anytime. Kasi pag magbukas yung corridor, it will be hindi yan permanent.
A newly brokered deal to allow humanitarian aid into Gaza. U.S. President Joe Biden announced Egypt agreed to let 20 trucks of aid into the Palestinian enclave through the Rafah crossing. But he did not specify when the delivery will begin.
Been on the phone for the last, I don't know, we've been on the ground a while. That's why we haven't taken off. With El Sisi. He agreed that what he would do is open the gate on to do two things. One, let up to 20 trucks through to begin with. Satterfield, my ambassador, is down there in Cairo now. He's going to coordinate this. He has my authority to do what is needed to get it done. They're going to patch the roads. They have to fill in potholes to get these trucks through.
Biden adds if Hamas militants will intercept the aid, it will be cut off.
But the point being that if Hamas confiscates it, or doesn't let it get through, or just confiscates it, then it's going to end because we're not going to be sending any humanitarian aid to Hamas if they're going to come be confiscated. That's the commitment that I've made. And So the bottom line is that El-Sisi deserves some real credit because he was very accommodating. And quite frankly, as everyone I have spoken to thus far since this trip began.
Israel has imposed a total blockade of Gaza, cutting off essential supplies like food, clean water and fuel following the brutal attacks by Hamas militants on October 7th. Israel says while it won't stop aid entering Gaza from Egypt, no supplies will pass through their border. Turning now to the aftermath of the deadly Gaza hospital blast, U.S. President Joe Biden appearing to side with Israel, saying early intelligence indicates this explosion was caused by a Palestinian armed group.
This is what remains of the parking lot of the Ahli Arab Hospital in Gaza City, where a massive blast on Tuesday killed hundreds of people. Arriving in Tel Aviv Wednesday to show support for Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, President Joe Biden said he was deeply saddened and outraged by the hospital explosion.
Based on the information we've seen to date, it appears the result of an errant rocket fired by a terrorist group in Gaza.
Biden said Israel has agreed that humanitarian assistance can begin to move from Egypt to Gaza and announced $100 million U.S. aid for Palestinians. He vowed to provide Israel what it needs to defend itself, but urged restraint in its retaliation.
You live by the rule of law. When conflicts flare, you live by the law of wars.
Netanyahu thanked Biden for his support. His government has pounded Gaza with airstrikes, killing 3,000 people, and ordered 2 million Gazans to evacuate ahead of an expected ground invasion in response to the militant group Hamas' brazen incursion on October 7th, which killed 1,400 people.
Hamas is responsible and should be held accountable for all civilian casualties.
Hamas blamed the hospital blast on an Israeli airstrike, while Israel said it was an errant rocket from the militant group Islamic Jihad. That group also denied responsibility. The hospital was considered a haven for Gazans fleeing Israeli attacks.
I don't know. A missile fell on us. We were on the floor. Everything got destroyed. We were destroyed.
The explosion and Israeli retaliation to Hamas have ignited massive protests in various cities, including in Lebanon, Jordan, Iran, Iraq, Tunisia, and Turkey. Demonstrators laid the blame on Israel. In Tel Aviv, Biden met with Israeli survivors of the October 7th Hamas attack. He had been scheduled to head next to Amman to meet leaders of Jordan, Egypt, and the Palestinian Authority. But the summit and the Jordan leg of the trip were scrapped following the blast. Patsy Widakuswara, VOA News.
The International Criminal Court urged to take action on Palestinian killings. Hundreds of pro-Palestine demonstrators marched to the ICC headquarters in the Netherlands in the aftermath of the deadly hospital blast in Gaza. Protesters blamed Israel for the attack, urging it to stop what they called a genocide.
We do believe in the international law, and here we are in the Netherlands, and this is the building of the International Criminal Court, where we come to ask for all the world criminals, and I believe that Netanyahu is committing world crimes and genocides against the Palestinians and against the innocents, and that's the reason why we came here to protest, and we take this opportunity so the world can see and hear the voice of the innocents and the victims.
Similar protests erupt across the world, including in Yemen, Tunisia, Egypt, West Bank, and the UK. The protesters are calling for a free Palestine and an end to the attacks on the besieged enclave.